Welcome. We're really glad to have you here today. We're very fortunate to have Luis Vargas, Principal Program Manager on the SQL team, and I'm Wynn Johnson, Senior Product Marketing Manager on the Data Platform CNE Marketing team. Luis, today, as we're here today, we're thinking mostly about SQL running on Azure VMs. Can you tell me why SQL runs best on Azure?
Totally. So first, let's talk about performance. So in Azure, we have the highest performance for SQL Server. One of the reasons is we have more storage bandwidth for these virtual machines. And what that means is the amount of data that these virtual machines can read and write from the storage is higher than in other clouds. Right? The next thing is we have a read cache that is local to the virtual machines. This read cache lives in an SSD. And that means that every time the SQL tries to read some data, it can read it in millisecond latency, right? Sometimes less than 1 millisecond. And that means that your queries are going to return faster. Second thing is, we have all the expertise for SQL Server, obviously in the SQL Server team, and we have used that expertise to make sure that these virtual machines that you create for SQL Server in Azure come pre-configured with all the best practices for whatever workload you want to run. So if you want to run, for example, transactional processing, we have all the best practices in place. Or same thing for data warehousing or BI, right? So you don't have to worry about those things as you will do in other clouds. The final thing is the SQL Server code itself uses Azure to make some operations better. And this is because we have both the code for SQL Server and the code for Azure. So we can do things, for example, to make backups really, really fast. So SQL Server can use the storage system in Azure so that backups can take seconds, even if a database is multi-terabytes. Right? So that's definitely something that is very important to have that highest performance. The second thing is we have a lot more support for the different options of SQL Server. So for example, obviously we have all the different versions, all the different editions, but on top of that, we have SQL Server Developer, which is a free SQL Server version for development and testing, and SQL Server Express, which is also free for a small workload. So you have a very small workload, like for a website, for example, you can use SQL Express and it's completely free. So again, the only cloud where you have those free offerings, right? We have Windows and Linux support. Right, so we started supporting now SQL Server on Linux as well, and we're the only cloud that offers that option for customers as well. And finally, we update these images with SQL Server very, very frequently. So on the same day when we release something like the new service pack, for example, for SQL Server, or if there is any critical fixes, for example, for security or performance for Windows or SQL, we have those fixes in the virtual machines on the same day when it's released. So very, very important to have that as well. The other aspect is the simplified management and all the control that we offer customers. So on one hand, we simplify operations, for example, like configuring high availability with Always On, and we have templates to automate that. We simplify things like automatically patching SQL Server and Windows or taking backups for all of those databases. So these are common operations that customers normally need to do. We can simplify them and automate them in the context of Azure. But outside of that, we still give 100% control to the customer. So if a customer wants to go and change whatever setting they want on Windows or on SQL Server, if they want to install whatever binary they want to have in that virtual machine, they can do it as well. So lots of automation and management, but at the same time, all the control that you want. And finally, we have some easy monitoring, for example, and alerting, so you can monitor on different situations if SQL Server is running, let's say, out of memory, or if you have a high number of transactions, for example, and you hit a deadlock, you can monitor those experiences and get alerted very easily as well. We have something called the Best Practice Advisor, only available in Azure. And what it does, it checks around 90 different best practices for SQL Server. So it will verify, for example, that you have all the security best practices in place, that you have all the high availability and business continuity best practices in place. So it's almost like having an expert that is continuously verifying your deployment and telling you how you're doing, right? And again, only available in Azure. It's very easy for customers to bring their licenses. So we know that we have a lot of customers that already own SQL Server licenses in their on-premises environment, and they can very easily bring them into Azure as well. So we have something called BYOL images, or images for bring your own license. And customers can easily create a virtual machine out of those licenses. They can just let us know that they're going to bring a certain number of licenses, and they can start using those virtual machines without having to pay for the SQL license because they already have them. So it's the only cloud where they can do that. Right? Very, very easy to bring your licenses. Actually, we're going to very soon allow customers to change between paying the SQL license per minute or bringing the license. We're going to allow them to do that so they can start paying per minute, for example. Mm-hmm. Right? And at some point, if they want to move and change the license, they will be able to do it in place very, very easily. So something else that is coming. And finally, we're a single vendor, right? Again, we own both the code for SQL Server and the code for Azure. And because of that, there is a single team to support both platforms, right? So if a customer runs into any type of issue, any type of situation, we can fix it all the way from the database system into the platform, right? And the virtual machines, the storage, the network, we own everything. So customers don't need to have different vendors supporting their deployments. Also, we provide consistency of experiences for SQL Server. So the same experience that you have for SQL Server running in your corporate environment is the same one that you're going to have in Azure Virtual Machine, right? It's the same one that you're going to have in Azure Stack, for example, which you can use now to build a private cloud, right? So all of that consistency, again, we're able to do because we have the code for SQL Server. And finally, SQL Server itself leverages Azure already today for many operations. So people who today use SQL Server 2014, for example, or 2016, they may know that we already have things like backup to Azure storage. So you can take some backups from your SQL Server and store them in Azure, or you can create replicas for high availability disaster recovery, where you can have your always-on secondaries running in Azure, for example, or you can stretch your database into Azure so that if your database is growing really, really fast, you can start pushing some of that data into Azure as well without having to worry for the storage management. So all of these are very good reasons why to host SQL Server in Azure. And I hope that answered your question.
Luis, that was very useful. I think it really helps us to kind of distill out exactly why SQL runs so well on Azure,
yep.
Even the best. So after all those things that you told us, what would you recommend somebody do?
Yeah, so at this point, the best thing is go and open a free trial in Azure. So you have $200 for free credit. You can go and start using, for example, SQL Server Developer Edition. So you can create one virtual machine with SQL Server Developer. It's going to be free license as well. So you can run for a whole month with SQL Developer on a virtual machine on SSDs, which is going to be pretty fast. And just try the offering, right? And if you're interested, obviously, you can go and try SQL Server on Linux as well, now that we have it in the platform.
Thank you very much, Luis. That was very informative and very helpful to understand how SQL runs on Azure VM better than anywhere else. Please take us up on that, the offer to use your $200 credit and spin up a VM today. Thank you so much.
Thank you.